That's right. It is now 2019, the first box of the year. Is it worth it? I don't know. I don't know if it is or not. Let's jump in and take a look and see if it is. All right, let's get right to the dibble. You know, the dibble. Dibble. McDibble. Johnny Dibble. Brain Dibble. I don't know. All right, first and foremost, we have the Weston Swim. This is actually pretty cool looking, pretty large. It is a monstrous little rattle trap looking beast. Of course, we gotta get it out of the box. First off, no one wants box stuff anyway, all right? We just want, whoops, we just want lures, folks. Wow, that's really smooth. All right, so this is just, this is not a, I don't know what this is. This is like a swim bait almost. It's kind of cool. It's got, oh, it's got one knocks in it. That's cool. All right, so basically inside of this bad boy here and here, you can kind of see some singular knockers to make some extra noise. It's got a really cool like green color here, shad style. A couple big hooks on the back here. These look like they're number twos. And a good little suspending 32 grams worth of cool bait. I think this is actually going to do really, really well, especially for like the winter season. This is something I can throw out and leave it out there sitting, suspending, and it should be able to get a bite. A little bit different, but I think that'll work well. Next up on, oh, what do they have that listed for? I bet that's expensive. Yeah, $13.99. That's a pretty expensive bait. Oh, this is cool. They've actually changed the dibble now to where it goes in like order of price, like least or most expensive to least expensive. That's really cool. That's something different. I would change the yellow and white though. Don't do yellow and white. Let us have some contrast here, folks. But other than that, that's not too bad. So next up, we have the Bagley Fat Balsa 2B at $10.99. And there she is. This is gonna look like a little thread fin color, guys. Very similar to like a square bill, but it's gonna be balsa. Actually, I take it back. This is a square bill. Traditional old, very old school swim bill, square bill. Very cool looking. I gotta say, I love the color on it. I love thread fin with a little bit of red for the gills. A little bit of orange on the belly. It's really pretty for balsa, so it's gonna be a lighter lure. It's got a couple wrap. Wow, those hooks are sharp. I don't know what kind of hooks you guys use, but boy, those are sharp. They're just some round hooks. But boy, they are little sharp buggers. I like this one. This is gonna float really well. It's gonna have a really good action because of how light it is. It's gonna really pop. It's really gonna hunt in the water. I'd like to see a little bit wider bill on this so it hunts a little bit harder. It gets a little bit more wiggle to it. But I'm sure this is gonna catch great fish. This thread fin color is great. I love the chartreuse. It's gonna work great in muddy or clear water. I mean, this is just all around a great little lure. You can deflect it off things, but not as much as your traditional square bill. So this is definitely more of like an open water style version. Don't go with like any other variation. Next up, ooh, Janko Fishing something. Some word I probably can't pronounce, so don't try and get me to pronounce it. But needless to say, it's gonna be a jerk bait, a 110 even. This thing's beautiful. I snuck a peek at this bad boy before we shot the video. Not gonna lie, I really like this jerkbait. It is super crispy. There she is. Look at that pearlized white, the little bit of brown around the eyes. That is pretty. That's a pretty little jerkbait. It's gonna be suspending. It's gonna probably go, I don't know, 5-6 feet deep. But that pearlized color, man, that is beautiful. It almost looks like there's a little bit of blue in there when you kind of angle it the right way. Like you give it a little tilt and bang, it hits you. This is, I mean, when it comes to winter baits, early spring baits, clear water, jerkbaits are what's up. Like, done, over with, that is the lure you want to throw. And especially with the rattles in here, they're kind of muted. They actually sound like they might be glass rattles inside, which is super cool. I love it. This is a beautiful, beautiful jerkbait. This is very similar to like the Mega Bass 110. It's got a similar curve on the back, less, but there's a little bit more of an arc in the Mega Bass. Does have the three hooks. It's very, like I said, very, very similar to the Mega Bass 110. That'll catch fish. That's going to flat out catch fish. Booyah. All right, so next up, look at that. That's kind of a cool look. What? All right, next up, we have the Big Bite Baits Battle Bug. Big Bite Baits Battle Bug. That's these bad boys. Let's see what we got. Gotta rip it open. Who does these things? Who makes me have to open stuff like this? It's a good way to make me crazy. Just leave it open, guys. You don't have to seal it like that. You don't have to do it. It's an extra step that you don't have to go through. Oh, it's a crop. I don't know why they're calling it a bug. It's a crop. That is straight up a craw. Oh, look at me craw. Look at the shimmer on that thing. Holy mackerel, guys. That is a lot of shimmer. What the heck did you guys send me? The Battle Bug Ozark Craw. Woo-hoo. That's different, man. I can smell plastic, though. Smells like Plastisol is what that smells like. That's a solid feel to it. It's not like too squishy, or you know, they can rip the claws off, but that's not too bad. The clarity on these is really good. Tons and tons of stuff inside of them. I mean, the amount of flake, I don't know if you guys can see how much flake that is, but my goodness, look at all the flake inside of that. What flake city. That is a ton of flake, guys. This is probably my favorite thing so far next to that jerkbait. I gotta say, though, this is a really, really good box so far. So far, everything in here is 100% something I would throw. The least likely thing so far for me would be that massive one, the number one, numero uno, the Weston. This thing's huge, but I'm gonna be able to whip this thing across the whole freaking body of water. It's gonna come through and look like a great shad, so. I'm not saying it's a bad lure. I'm just saying that's the least, the one that I like the least so far. Next up is the Jerk Shads by Z-Man. A lot of people probably don't know that Z-Man actually makes a ton of soft plastics, and this is one of the ones that they make. What I don't really understand is why I have like two sheets here. Like, I don't really get that. This is a waste of material for me. I thought maybe, you know, they were supposed to put something inside of it, but that's not how this, it's literally a pouch. Like a random extra pouch. And I'm sure this piece of paper explains it, but I'm never, ever, ever going to look at that piece of paper. I just want the lure that's inside of it. So, simple fluke, guys. This is just a simple, everyday, beautiful-looking fluke. This is going to be great on the river. It's a gorgeous color, this two-tone laminate that's going on here, where the top is this super-duper silver color with that white bottom. There we go. That's pretty, guys. That's real pretty. This is going to work great in rivers and really anywhere, but it's a little soft, little squishy for me, so I have a feeling these are going to get shredded real easy. Fish are going to tear these apart. So for me, this is something I'm going to throw in my rivers for smallies, but I can't really complain about that. This is going to get bit. There's quite a few of them, it feels like, in here, maybe. Quantity of five, that's not too bad. I should be able to get 10 fish off that. And, you know, they're listing the price for this at $4.49. $3 probably is the better price tag, I'd say, but I'd take it. I like it. It's good. I'm good with that. Throw it in the bag. And last but not least, guys, we have the hooks to go along with it. 5-inch fluke hooks. Bang. Looks like these go by Penetration Hooks F is the name of the company. And they're hooks with keeper. So I wonder if this says anything. These are packaged in Korea. Now, hopefully not North Korea. That would just be weird. But, you know, some cool hooks. You can see those in the lighting. Bang. Boom. Looks like the Superman logo. Do you see that? It's Superman. Hey, hold up. Hold up. You can get away with that stuff in Korea. I don't know if you can get away with that here in the United States, boys. Bang. Superman. That's crazy. All right, guys. Keeping it short. You know, it's the winter. I don't have a lot to do. I'm losing my mind. The second one of these comes in, I run into my basement, start shooting a video. Can you tell I'm crazy? I feel like I'm losing my mind. I have been making lures though. This whole back wall back here behind me, all lures that I've created, which is super fun. One of which being this little baby bass color. I think it looks super cool. Just saying, if you want to get a couple, hit me up. Inexpensive. Those are like all $5 a pop. Just saying. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, please, please, please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to the video. If you would, down below in the comment section, list what lure you like the best. And if you want to see all of these bad boys behind me, I'm happy to show you guys all of them and how I make them with something as simple as an airbrush. Let's just put that away before I break more stuff. And as always, guys, until next time, happy foozin'.